Hey y'all, welcome to issue number 8. This week we're going to talk about 3 different things. First, we are going to make breakfast. 2, we are going to make rosemary infused olive oil, okay? I was watching Elliot Homestead. I love her channel and she did it. I was just like, whoa, let me try it. So I tried it and I think it was successful. And then 3, we are going to clean my silver utensils. Not silver plated, but real silver utensils that I've had for a while. It's been like a year and it's tarnishing and I need to clean it because I love to use it again. I haven't used it in a while because I could taste the metal. So you're going to clean that with me as well. So hopefully you guys enjoy it. You guys get some information and try some of these things on your own. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow me on IG, okay? All right, enjoy. So during the week, we do not get to eat breakfast because we are all so very busy. So I take it upon myself to make a big meal on the weekend. I usually make bacon, egg, and toast, or bacon, egg, and pancake, or bacon, egg, and avocado toast. But this weekend, we are making bacon, egg, and toast. My favorite bread is potato bread. I love it. My husband loves it. We both enjoy it. My sister-in-law love it as well. And this week I use the ghee butter to put it on the collard ghee by itself. But I love this ghee butter. I just recently discovered it and it tastes better than regular butter. And it is way more expensive than regular butter, but it is so good that I am sticking to it. I use that, and I know that my cast iron love that butter as well. Use that to butter my toast and cook the bacon, cook that our egg. I don't like to always scramble it. I like to, like, you know, have a little bit of yolk in it as well. So with my, and I use my little season, and I use my salt that I made on it to season the eggs. If you don't know, watch my video on how to make it. It's really good and it goes on almost everything. I love that salt. Here I am making rosemary infused oil. I learned this from Elliot Homestead. I love watching her channel because she cooks a lot and I love to cook, and she has a farm and her kitchen is super dope. Like, I love it. So I'm always learning something new from a channel. So anywho, so I poured the rosemary in a nice small pot. I was making a big batch. I was making a small batch because I didn't have that much rosemary. It's my first time doing it, so I didn't want to do anything too large. So I poured in a small little pot, cut a couple of stems of rosemary, threw it in there, had it simmering for about 30 minutes on like level 1 or 2, very very low heat, you know, because you don't want to cook it, you just want it to boil a little bit or simmer so the rosemary can be infused in the oil. And that's exactly what I did. I let it sit for 30 minutes low heat. And by the time I was done, it smelled amazing. Rosemary aroma coming from it. It was really, and I used it like the same day to make rice and cook other meals, like cook my lamb. Yeah, let me know how it goes. So I know most of the time nowadays, we don't really have silver utensils, like pure silver utensils. It's usually silver plated. However, I love the vintage utensils, the curvature on the forks and the spoons, the designs. Like, they really took their time to make sure they designed this or these items with love and care and just so much creativity. I don't know what happened, but one day I just got into it. I was just like, I want some old vintage utensils. So I got some. I used it for a while. I actually got it for my husband's birthday. I did a whole Italian theme, and it was just a perfect utensils for the whole vibe that I was going with. However, it tarnished because, once again, it's silver, right? It tarnished, and I haven't really been using it because with the tarnish, you kind of taste it when you use it. It tastes like metal. I don't like it. And I was watching Rajiv. If you watch his YouTube channel, it's pretty dope. He finally got a YouTube channel. If you don't know him by his real name, is Kevin G from Mean Girls. Like, he does stuff like this all the time, and I just love it. So thank God he made a video about how to clean your silver utensils. I said, I need to clean mine. I don't know what to do or what to use. I know there's a silver cleaner, but I don't know how much chemicals is in there. Then I want to use that.
So he gave an option to use glass cleaner or sanitizer, the ones without aloe. I tried it, okay? I tried the glass cleaner and the sanitizer. They both didn't really work for my utensils. I think mine is too tarnished to use something not as abrasive. And he warned us to not use baking soda at all. But I'm just like, my drink is tarnished. I need whatever harsh, whatever to take it off. So I tried it with baking soda. And I was just like, oh, shoot, this is working. So the first one I cleaned was this one. Right? And this is the dirt or the tarnish that came off. I said, oh shoot, baking soda's working. Let's see. So I said, well, let me get the rest of it, right? I'm using my, this is Shiseido, I know this is like super bougie, unnecessary, but this is Shiseido cotton pad. I didn't get Shiseido cotton pad just to clean my silver, that's dumb. I use this to clean my face, you know, but that's a cotton pad that I have. And it's good to use cotton pad because it's softer and it's easier. It's softer, it's not as abrasive or harsh. Because first when I did, I was just like, ain't nothing coming off. That I realized is the lighting, right? Oh, it's coming off. So you're just going to take the cotton round, dip it in water, make sure your cotton pad is wet, cotton round, cotton pad, whichever. I dipped it in the, you see that? I dipped it in the baking soda. And just start rubbing it in there. And I definitely want to collect more silver utensils. I think they're so pretty. I have another one that whoever had it kept it real well. No tarnishing or nothing. It looked like it's just new. And this one actually have letters on it. Because you know, this is just so crafty back in the day. They took their time with everything. I wish we were like that now. But we are not, sadly. Like this one says, 1881 Rogers, Anita L. Limited Enchantment is the name of it. And then I'm going to wash it off when I'm done. Let's do this last one. I definitely want to get more. So, actually, before I move forward to the next one, I just wash off so we don't have, like, baking soda sitting on all of them. I'm going to do the real cleaning in the sink when I'm done. But for now, let's just wash it off. And that black you see is basically the silver coming off. But that's fine. I'd rather have the silver come off a bit than taste tarnished food. Tarnished utensil. That's not it. Yeah, I definitely want to go to an antique store, the vintage store, and get some more silver. I want to have a little collection. I know lately I've been talking about a lot of collection. I just want stuff that will last that I could pass on because unfortunately, nowadays, stuff just don't, it's not made with good quality or with care and, you know, time. It's just, everything's just rushed. You know, it's not as good as it used to. So this one is done as well. So let's go wash this off really quick. Okay, so now we are done. It's washed off now with soap and I use a fiber cloth to wash, to clean it off. That's done and this is what it looks like now. I got it from Etsy. It's like $4 or $8 a piece of five. I don't really remember. And you pick, you kind of make your own set. You pick what you want. Obviously, it's a little pricey on Etsy because somebody else have to go find it at a thrift store or a vintage store and bring it and sell it. But definitely, I want to try that first if I really liked it. And I do, so next time I am going to go to vintage or the antique shop and collect my own because you can get it for like 80 cents, $1. So yeah, I'm happy. I'm so glad it worked because I really, it's so beautiful that I was not using it because it's so tarnished. So no more better taste. So yeah, so that is that. I hope if you have any silver utensils, try and see if it works. Maybe the glass cleaner or the sanitizer will work for you. If not, try the baking soda. It worked. Can't complain. All right? So, yeah.
Yes, I'll be